Don Hawk, Vice President of Business Affairs for Charlotte Motor Speedway SMI, here at Charlotte Motor Speedway. Got a big announcement coming up about the Legends Million race that's coming up in a month away. What's going on?
Actually, Jason, it's not a big announcement. It's a huge announcement. It's actually an unprecedented announcement. What we're going to announce today is that not only are we paying the $1 million that we said we're going to pay for Legend cars to race in the United States of America, which is the single biggest purse ever offered, obviously, for that kind of a short track venture, but we've now decided to enlarge this event by allowing three different divisions to compete for a substantial amount of cash. The A main will remain the same with $250,000 to win to the winner of that A main 30 car field. And we haven't changed that. We haven't messed with that at all, and we don't think we want to. What we have done to make it more appealing for the masters, the young lions, the semi-pros, is we've now offered an A main for them, which is going to be set up in a concept with a deal or no deal structure. You win the A main, you have the option to take as a master $30,000 in cash, which is the most money ever paid in a legend car purse in the United States of America, period. But you have the chance to pass on a portion of that and take a ride into the race for $250,000 to win, $100,000 for second, $50,000 for third. So it's going to be deal or no deal. So we're going to be having Jason, a competitor, you and I are going to be standing there. You just won the Masters division, and you're going to decide whether you want to take the cash or multiply the cash. We'll give you that option, but you can't have both.
Tell me, what came to this decision to do this? Because I know the big announcement months ago of having a $1 million race was big enough as is. Now this adds even more money into the pot.
Yeah, here's what happened. Is it's still $1 million. It's just spread out different in the way that we pay the A mains. But we had a real large contingent of masters who said, look, I think I'm good, but I don't know if I'm good enough to beat the pro guy. If you had a purse that was even a substantial amount, I'd come race in it and I'd stay to watch the $1 million race. The young lions and a semi-pro, same kind of conversation. What they did is they approached us, basically said, you could sign up another 50 or 100 cars if I knew I had skin in the game and I wasn't racing at a handicap. And so what we did is, which we haven't touched on yet, is the young lions and the semi-pros will be racing for $25,000 to win. Here's the unique things about those. Several things. Number one, last place in the A main for the pro series pays $10,000, which is 10 times the average winning purse in legend car racing in the United States of America. Most people race for a grand. We're going to pay 10 grand to finish last. Then you move that over to the next column. In the Masters, they're going to pay $1,000, which is twice your entry fee to finish last. And by the way, it's round numbers. It's a little more than that. And in the Young Lions Semi-Pro, it's going to pay a grand to finish last in that A-Main. So again, it's twice the amount you paid to get in the dance, and you still have a chance, if you win it, to say, I got cash in hand, or I can multiply it. In the case of a young lion or semi-pro, if their car is really hooked up and they win 25 Gs and they were running really, really good, same lap times per se as maybe the pro division, they're going to look at it and have the chance to 10 times the multiple or take the cash and run.
How cool is this that this whole big thing is actually going to be live on Speed Channel? I know the days leading up to it, I'm assuming they're going to do some coverage, but the actual race day, they're going to have live coverage of this whole event, including these mains.
That's correct. It's neat because Speed is excited about this. They're going to have the ability to film live what's happening here. And again, it's unprecedented. It's big. It's huge. In the words of Bruton Smith, it's large. I mean, it's something that is really, really outstanding. But guess what? It gets more exciting and gets a little bit of drama to it when you have somebody that wins who, let's say, is a 5 or 6 time repeating Masters champion. He's winning and he's looking at a handful of cash, knowing he can do almost 10 times that well if he wins the next event. I mean, part of the drama of the day is going to be just in front of the TV camera, having a competitor standing next to me, or Brute, nor Marcus, and saying, I want to pass or play, deal or no deal. That's, to me, that's a little bit of drama itself, off track.
I know with Speed, with the purse, with this new format, everything is going to really start ramping up with the car counts. I know you have over 100 drivers pre-entered. How many do you think that you're going to get total?
I'd be shocked. if this doesn't bring 100 and change in each division, I won't even understand why. Because you have people coming up to you during a normal season where Summer Shootout pays better than most places, where the NX Point Fund pays better than anything in America for a Legend card or a Bando. It pays, I mean, it's just, it is what it is. If it doesn't go by 150 a class, 300 more cars, I'm shocked. I'm astonished. I'd have to, you know what I'd have to do is, seriously, Jason, you can quote me on this, I'd have to say, what do I need to do next? Stand on my head and give away what? Because that's a huge amount of cash. And so we're trying to incentivize them to come here, but we don't want to lose emphasis on this. We're going to have some family fun. We're going to have some entertainment. We're going to have some cotton candy. We're going to have some popcorn. We're going to have hot dogs. This is going to be 3 days that is going to be like you went to something other than just a car race.
Tell me a little bit about the fact that when you have all these car, this car count a little bit lower this year with the Summer Shootout, you're boosting it with this $1 million race, the economy, the way it is right now, with all that factored in and the fact that you guys are doing this $1 million race, do you think this is going to actually help the low budget racer and put the low budget racers in Legends cars again, also giving a national scene? Maybe some racer that's up in Wisconsin that doesn't even know what a Legends car is going to see it on TV, see what's going on out here, and say, you know what, I can afford that.
I think it's a great question. What we're finding out now is there's a host of phone calls that are being made, and it's, will you lease me a car? Will you rent me a car? Do you have any used cars we can buy? Guess what? U.S. Legends decided we're going to start leasing cars. So, you know, that kind of thing is happening. The other thing on the economy is, we are following a chairman of the board's philosophy, and that is when things get tight, you got to actually spend more to just get everybody's support, to have everybody feeling better about this thing. So if you think about the change, I don't want to lose sight that it's $1 million. That's important. I don't want to lose sight of the fact we're paying $250 to win the main event. I don't want to lose sight of the fact we're paying an unprecedented $30 to win the Masters. I don't want to lose sight that we're paying $25 to win this Young Lions semi-pro. But what I want to emphasize is dead last place pays twice what it costs to enter in those two divisions. And in the main event, it's 10 times what it costs to not only enter, but it's 10 times what it normally pays to win. So we're trying to feed the money all the way through the purse. We're trying to make it so that when you come here, you don't have to reach in your pocket and it costs a fortune to race.
Tell me about the future of this. I know we've got to get through next month first and get through this event. But is this just a one-time deal, or do you see this as next year and the following year as a continuation with the $1 million event and even getting bigger, kind of like the All-Star Race does here at this track at Charlotte, how it keeps getting bigger every year?
Jason, the reason I love doing interviews with you is you always do your homework. And so apparently you've either talked to Eddie Gossage or Chris Powell, because they've both already contacted Marcus Smith and said, I want the event at Las Vegas. I want the event at Texas next year. And actually one of those two called up the chairman of the board and said, why didn't I get first dibs on it? So the nice thing about it is first dibs came here because Summer Shootout's here, U.S. Legends headquarters is here, and it seems to make a lot of sense since this was such a historic place for the Legends cars to run, for this to be the first place for it to happen. So we're not going to predict that it's going to be something we're going to move yet. We're not going to predict that we're even going to do it again yet, because I'm going to tell you, I need your help. Jason, I'm going to ask you a question right now. Can you help me to spread the word that we have now added two divisions for the most outrageous, unprecedented amount of cash, and I need to get it to everybody in America? I'll be flying this weekend to California. Scott's got me all over the country. I'm going to California this weekend to Infineon. There's a Legends car race there, and after the Legends car, I'm meeting with them in the driver's meeting, and then after the event, and some of those folks are already signed up, but those that haven't, I'm going to further entice them with this new appealing change we made. I fly from there. I believe I come home for 2 days. He lets me stay home two actual whole days. And then Cooper's got me headed to New Hampshire. Guess what we have in New Hampshire? Oh, wow, we have a cup race, but there's also a Legend car race. And I'm going to work that around the garage again and again try to work on that car count, let the information go out. And so for the next, my next 2.5-3 weeks, I'm going to be all over America, from the East Coast to the West Coast, up to New England. I am going to be selling that this is the biggest thing since sliced bread, and it's warm sliced bread.
One last question on that. You referenced sliced bread, so we're going to go there with the NASCAR contingent. Joey Logano, obviously nicknamed sliced bread. There's a lot of NASCAR contingencies that are either driving this race or owning cars and putting other people in them. Tell me about some of the names you've heard.
Well, it's interesting. David Reagan's already in. Mike Wallace actually entered at Kentucky Speedway, Chrissy Wallace's daughter. Jeff Bodine has already entered. There's an interesting development that happened last night here at the Speedway. G.E. Chapman from our engine department was shaking down a car for Reed Sorensen. Now, why in the world is our guy shaking down a car for Reed Sorensen if he has no intention on being here? Or maybe he's putting somebody else in the car, but it was a car for Reed Sorensen. That's all I know. I can tell you that my BlackBerry, this little thing right in here, and I'll even show it to you because I'm not
showing. Just don't show your number.
And I'm not afraid to show my number. I'll take all calls. I take all bets. You know that. And the interesting—I don't mean gambling bets. I mean I take all comers. If we deal the cards, we're willing to deal with the circumstances. But what I wanted to tell you was, in here, I've been negotiating with Joey Logano's agent. They had a conflict of interest, meaning another event. We believe that we might have circumvented that from happening, and that Joey might join our ranks. We know for a fact that Kelly Earnhardt has mentioned that she would like to race. So, you know, I don't want to say that Logano's in yet. I don't want to say that Kelly Earnhardt's in yet. I don't want to say that Reed Sorensen's in yet. I don't want to say that Clint Bowyer's in yet. I don't want to say that Kyle Busch is in yet. But I know that they've all had either cars or uniforms started to be designed. At least the rumor mill's leaking that out pretty good. So we'd like to think that's exciting, but we don't want to say we're name dropping. But you asked the question, so I'll drop the names.